Hello everyone, hope you all are doing well. In my previous tutorial, we were continuing to analyze battery historian logs. So we saw this graphical representation, how to retrieve data from it. Also, we saw how to get aggregated check-in stats. Next, we saw device power estimates. Then we saw user space wake lock, sync manager syncs, job scheduler, CPU usage, how to come to know which app is using most of the CPU, how to come to know which app is using most of the mobile network. All these details we saw. So today we'll continue to analyze them. So we had stopped here. Today we'll start with mobile traffic rate. So again, which app was using most of the mobile traffic? So here YouTube again, then CureFit and Chrome will come like that based on your priorities. Here we get the data. Next, Wi-Fi scan activity per app. So per app Wi-Fi scan activity, that duration we can see, count we can see. Then Wi-Fi full lock activity, we can see wake locks, sorry, Wi-Fi full lock. Kernel wake sources related to kernel, which are the wake up sources. Kernel wake up reasons, what are the reasons for the wake up. Then app wake up alarms. So wake up, which app was using most of the wake up alarms? We can see Google services is in the top list. Then comes Ola cabs, then comes Chrome, then Instagram. GPS use, which app was using GPS? We can come to know your ping ID and Instagram, two apps are using. Camera, WhatsApp was using camera. And time spent in each app. So in each app, so this is the important data. So when we have few issues like my battery is draining very fast, I don't know which apps are using most battery, that time we can analyze these logs, and especially time spent in each app. So here YouTube 38, so top, it was top means it was in the foreground. So 38 minutes YouTube has been used. And it was in background for 976 milliseconds. So YouTube was the most widely used app, and we can hence conclude YouTube was consuming more charge, battery charge. And this is the app which is responsible for your battery drain. Then comes Google services, then comes WhatsApp, then Chrome and CureFit, two apps are coming in a row. So we can come to know which app is using more charge here. Okay, so that was about this one. The last one thing I wanted to show y'all, we can also analyze based on an application. For example, if I click on this choose an app, we'll get all the apps which are installed in my Android device, the device from where I have collected battery historian. So from that device, whichever app I can click, and I can analyze the battery. For example, here I will choose YouTube. So com.google.android.youtube. So only for YouTube app stats will be switched. So my application package name is com.google.android.youtube, and I can see the version name 1541.35, version code I can see, the UID, unique ID of my app, device estimated power use. So totally it's using 30% almost of my battery, and it was 17 times it was foreground. 17 times YouTube was brought to foreground in a duration of 2 hours 41 minutes 41 seconds. So almost for 3 hours YouTube has run, and 17 times it was brought into foreground. It has used CPU for 40 minutes 46 seconds, that is CPU user time, and CPU system time is 25 minutes 50 seconds. All those details. So audio, it has used audio out of 2 hours 39 minutes, out of which it was used 32 times, it has used audio. We can see that details. So only for YouTube we can see all this particular details. Network information, we can see how much mobile data it has transferred. 304.88 MB of total mobile data YouTube has transferred. And I was not using Wi-Fi here, so mobile data transferred. So 289.3 it has received, and 15 it has transmitted. Similarly, only when it was in the background. 191.4 kb it has received and 156.3 kb it has transmitted. Wi-Fi I was not using, so Wi-Fi is zero. So the same data which you see here in the form of packets, it is shown here. Mobile packets transferred, received, transmitted, all those things. And mobile active timeout, how much it was active, how much time it was idle. Modem transfer time also we can see. Also we can see the wake locks, which all wake locks YouTube was using. So it was using window manager wake lock, and it was using YouTube service, system service, job service. All those things we can see. So all this are zero. Here we can see window manager wake lock it's using. We all know wake lock is used to keep the device awake. Then we can see alarm info. Then we can see which services YouTube is using. So background player service it's using and system job service it's using. Then process info. Time spent on top means when it is in the foreground, how much time it is spent. So 2 hours 41 minutes, as I already told, YouTube was in foreground. 4 seconds it was in background. Time spent in cached. Cached apps you all know, right? To prevent time from accessing it from the memory, cached apps reduce that turnaround time. So 1 hour it was in cached. Then processes, this is the process name, schedule job we can see, and also we can see the sensor, which sensor YouTube has used. YouTube has used accelerometer, 3-axis accelerometer, android.sensor.accelerometer, for a total of 2 hours 37 minutes 49 seconds 863 milliseconds. So like this, whichever app we are interested in, that app we can browse and we can come to know all the details regarding that particular app. So that's all I wanted to inform you all about battery historian. We saw this graphical representation, what each parameter means we saw. Then we saw the different parameters here, user space, sync, job sync, kernel wake locks, camera, GPS, and we also saw how to search information based on a particular application. So using this, we can analyze the battery discharge of our device and develop apps in such a way they consume less battery. I hope this was informative and helpful. Thanks everyone for your time. I'll see you all in my next video with another new topic. Until then, everyone, take care. Bye.